for the rear leg ground kick. There's the first one from Petchdam. If he goes to the bottom, let's see what happens. It's probably the academy.
He's kind of a range finder.
There's the overhand from Momotaro. Here comes the power. Petchdam with the elbow on the inside. They tie up now. Petchdam tries to turn him around. A little tango against the wall. And
it's just as Petchdam picked up
Muay Thai world champion. Round
you can see the swagger coming off of Momotaro, jetting in and out, not paying any regard to the power of Petchdam.
Momotaro's peaking right now. There's the
rear. You gotta keep in mind, like, that, you know, Petchdam's orthodox kickboxing is not the same thing right now.
That wasn't kickboxing, however, this world title. World's largest martial arts fantasy game, with one fantasy on the one super app, only 19% of fans. Tipping a win for Momotaro.
Stop!
Referee Delapsis breaks them. Ball of Asia Arena, not an empty seat in the house. And they are loving this one. Big uppercut there from Momotaro. That's him again! Having to pick himself up a second. Jab two. And dumps him again.
Timing for moving his legs, and he's able to kind of deflect.
So far. Roundhouse kick there from Petchdam. Short right hand from Momotaro. Inside the phone booth now.
Great kick.
Needs to pull the trigger on that left leg, but Momotaro's movement has hindered it.
That's exactly right. It's that movement. It's that unconventional, you know, almost that kickboxing or karate style that Momotaro is starting to do in that clinch. When he does go inside and engage, watch him cut the ankle.
4 ounce gloves here. All of that. 4 ounce gloves from Muay Thai. The larger gloves for kickboxing. Uppercut there from Momotaro. Elbow from Petchdam, looking to crack it against the bridge of the nose.
Stop!
And
stop.
The luck. The winner of the round gets allocated 10 points. The less dominant athlete gets 9 points. Nice knee there from Petchdam. And they are barking instructions for Petchdam from the Petchyindee Academy corner. Crossing elbow from the baby shark. Momotaro.
When Momotaro keeps changing.
Now with Momotaro. He did the damage to the body like that against Josh Tonner. It was in the neck of him. I think he may have just, it could be too over.
Momotaro has a speed advantage. He is lightning fast.
Momotaro pitching so many opponents, so many titles over the years. But that's what he doesn't like. He doesn't like getting punched in the face. Petchdam Petchyindee Academy.
And that jab is what's doing it. It's setting everything else up. It is scoring on the body.
There's a Kramati stance on the Japanese athlete. Catch him. Grounds up. Looks for a tap. The volume, the output high here. Nice knee to the upper right rib cage from Petchdam.
Petchdam needs more of that inside that clinch, but that left kick so body of Momotaro.
And lessens the target area, the more you open up your entire front body and side for those roundhouse kicks.
Stop!
But it does.
Momotaro doing so well. He is not allowing Petchdam to get into that range where Petchdam can fire off that rear leg ground kick that is prime weapon for the time.
Stop! Stop!
You hear from Momotaro, jumps into range, fires the uppercut, reaches him, looks for
stop,
another dump,
stop,
won't get it. Referee Delapsis
overhand right from DJ. Rodtang staying close. Body shot again from the top. Front kick to a round kick from DJ. On the outside. Rodtang with the support remaining in the Muay Thai round. How about Rodtang getting out there? DJ lands a good hook. Body shot Rodtang. DJ's back. Back from DJ. That was the punch of the Muay Thai round. Big right hand from Rodtang. Inside. DJ forced to cover up. There's an elbow. There's a knee. And DJ's on his bike. Rodtang outside low kick. Front kick from DJ. Rodtang. Big left hook from Rodtang. DJ moving. Inside bike. Overhand right from DJ. A cracker. A beauty from Rodtang in the clinch. A knee from DJ. The crowd. DJ. He's swung into the power side. Only 9 remaining in the Muay Thai round.
With the Muay Thai rule set, he keeps clinching and trying to look for a tie-up. But Rodtang is doing a great job of pressuring him into that.
Into Olivia Clark.
He can't count Rodtang out. One shot can end the night. So you know DJ and Dragon
the usual 5 minutes that DJ is in.
Back foot. Circling the cage really well now.
In the second round. And the first takedown attack from DJ. Oh, we go to the ground. He's got the back of Rodtang.
They're dry, Michael. They're not that sweaty yet. This is a bad spot for Rodtang. Rodtang should use the wall as a defensive mechanism to try to keep DJ from fully taking his back.
Rodtang carrying the weight of DJ, posting up on that right arm. The Thai defending as DJ's going to try and soften him up, try and look for the choke, look to strangle him. A bad spot for Rodtang with 1:35 remaining. Rodtang defending. Rodtang's never been in this position, never, ever in his life. With a 12-time world champion on his back, trying to choke him out.
Good defense there, how he had using his arm to prevent the hand from sliding out there. You can see DJ's trying to pull out the hand. There
this
he goes.
It.
Now it's under the neck.
This is it!
Rodtang's got to relax. He could panic tap.
Rodtang! Can he hold on?
Oh, he pulled the hand at the top. That's great defense. DJ's going to transition. He goes back to it. Rodtang's got to continue to fight that top hand.
Rodtang! Is he going to tap?
No.
It's a sweep! It's a sweep! It's out cold! That's good night, Irene!
I see a way. That right kick lands to the body.
You can see him stalking his prey. Measures with the far too evasive.
But he's got great balance. He says he spent hours on the mat working on that takedown defense.
Did you say that?
This is crazy! This is bananas! 37! When Parr tries to get on the inside, a short flurry from the Aussie. He's backing up the line. Wayne backed up against the fence here, takes a right hand, goes down! Alistair Austin puts a count on Wayne Parr. He took a clean right hand.
Seven, eight, look forward.
Wipe off the gloves by the count of eight. Okay. Oh, the left hand. Heavy artillery early.
He's check those kicks.
Top of the right.
He's going to try to close
Edward
that.
Eduard Folayang jumped. Left hook from Eduard Folayang. And Wayne Parr remains composed. Body shot from... Spinning back. He sticks it with the right hand. To the side kick does Wayne. Out timing on those leg kicks. Spinning hash of leg kicks. Up to the ribs.
Time cutting off the angle. You can see he's counting.
Ridges forward, always coming forward.
John Wayne Parr watching the footage rather than stepping forward.
To the body with the right. Out of every pore. Intestinal fortitude. Body shot. Spinning a heel from Folayang. Folayang, Rick Franklin, your thoughts. He's got Folayang on the back foot. Outside low kick. Behind the right hand. Gets out of the way of the counter. Checks the low kick. Round to Wayne. Jab two. Both men in orthodox stance. Wayne Parr returns the favor. Doubles up.
Gonna try to catch him coming in.
Side kick.
Well, that left hook.
Power salvos from the Filipinos. Digs to the liver like he's digging for all to the bread basket. Of Eduard Folayang. Ah, who's knockout. Wayne goes downstairs. Kick coming. Again, hooks it there.
With those leg kicks, we missed.
Hoping for Eduard Folayang after the lead thigh of the Filipino.
We're starting to see Parr put those punches around.
Tremendous hands of him. Mundane, of course.
Do it. He's just kind of taking where he keeps throwing it. He might be
outside lane. No hands over the top from Folayang. Parr! The head kick! On the top of the ear. Another hook kick! And another! Throws the right hand lead. Jab. Ten seconds. A rolling thunder. A cartwheel kick.
Eduard Folayang.
The champion, Tan Lee, in the all black. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. And it's Gary Tone and the grappler, who starts with the high kicks.
Shonen comes out.
Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you.
Stances, very high volume, engaging his movement, understanding where things are at. Uh-oh. Conan chooses to pull a guard, goes after a leg. This is what we talked about.
Ooh, nice right hand. Hand there from Tom Lee. Conan hoping to sink a sub early on here.
Throws on the Ashigarami. That's a leg lace. Here he goes, attacking that outside heel hook. Let's see what Tom Lee can do. Tom Lee trains under Ryan Hall, who's one of the best leg lockers in mixed martial arts. Let's see how Tom Lee chooses to defend this. Good defense. Man, Gary Tonin's like a vice-like grip on that leg.
Gary,
Wow, look at him. Oh, man, Michael. That's the danger of leg locks. You leave your face exposed. Wow.
That was the leg lock defense. See that? Smack the guy in the face as hard as you can. Just punch his face as hard as you can. That was the leg lock defense. And it worked.
Look at this.
In trouble here. No, Tan Lee is composed, he's calm, he's relaxed, he knows what to do. He wants to posture up, and he wants to punch the face. And when he gets that opening, that's what he does. He cracks into the orbital, and that's it. Gary's out cold. The second and third punches were icing on the cake. You see the eyes roll back in Gary's head. Beautiful getter on this angle. The eyes roll back. Punches two and three were just the finishing touch. He was gone there. Gone. Two. Out. See the eyes? Gone. Three. My goodness. That was nasty. That is Tan Lee. And he's still 100% finishing rate.
Stop! Yud Kai Kao! fair tag.
The traditional southpaw versus orthodox matchup.
Left hand. Look down that kick. He's closing that distance though. So. Nice.
Cross hook, little shuffle step into the last right hand.
Disrupt the rhythm of Wushu side of life. There's that single leg. Shoots in, immediately gets the back. Tan Lee tried to roll through. You can see now Wushu is
up Tan Lee with his knees.
See, he's got that hand blocked up with two hands on one, so there's no place for that hand of Tan Lee to go. But good job by Tan Lee to get back up to his feet. But that's what Sada Live does. He likes to use that seatbelt to pull his opponents down.
What Tan Lee wants to do right now is try to get his hips on the right underhook on the left side of Yusuf Sada Live. But Sada Live doing a great job of keeping pressure with the wrist control.
See how Tan Lee's trying to roll through. He's trying to go anywhere. Now he's got that right arm trapped. And this is a bad spot. Possible armbar right there.
That's a straight arm lock there. Not a good position.
Look at him getting that submission. Yusuf Sadalaya getting inventive.
Takes the back off that transition. What a transition by Sadalaya. He has a little Kimura lock on the left arm of Tan Lee. Look for him to attack that.
He's controlling up the right arm there, and he's got the arm controlled, and he's got that with the leg. Look at that. Hard for Tan Lee. Tan Lee tries a somersault out. Good job, but he gives up the guillotine. Front headlock position for Sada Life as he circles to the back.
High level transition by both these athletes.
You can see that Tan Lee's trying to do all the right things. All the roll throughs are usually escapes that he's probably gotten out of in practice, but Sada Life is a different type of grappler. His pressure is constant.
Sada Life
driving that arm in.
One step ahead tonight, making all the necessary adjustments every time Tan Lee tries to escape. Got some good knees from side control. Still controlling the left arm of Tan Lee, putting pressure on his back. This prevents Tan Lee from standing up.
He's always trying to drag people around. Look at him. He had that seatbelt position. He tried to pull him to his back to secure a more dominant position. You might want to soften Tan Lee up here because he's only got 18 seconds to work. Might not find the submission, but he is able to land a little bit of ground pound here.
That's again.
That right arm that's controlling the left arm of Tan Lee right now. Look for him to go to the rear naked choke position here. He's setting that up. He's going to the back. Look for him to give up.
Yusuf Sadalaya from Russia as Tan Lee lands a nice big shot! What a head kick! Yusuf Sadalaya trying to close the distance.
Switches it up down the middle. Yusuf Sadalaya thinks it's a high kick again. But Tan Lee switches the high kick into a knee straight down the line.
Single-legged attempt here from Shimoishi. Can he get the takedown? Drives out with Shimoishi. Peppers in a couple of right hands. Threads another one. Knees here from Shimoishi. Muay Thai clinch. Throws the knee to the midsection. Nicely done. High knee. Backs up Ariel Sexton now. High knee again. Catches him before. Oh, the counter right hand. Drops Shimoishi.
Found a spot and drops Shimoishi. He might still be wobbled a little bit. This is the chance for Sexton to really let it go.
Goes to the body of Shimoishi. Kim Ching right on top. That counter right hand from Sexton. What a beauty. Top position. Drills a knee. And another one. That'll give you a headache. Shimoishi's going to need a box of Panadol.
Man, that was giving me a headache. Those were nasty. Those elbows from the top under the lats right there of Shimoishi.
Another one of those short range punches.
Takedown there from Shimoishi. Now Shimoishi's turn from the top. Can he land some ground and pound? Can he land some punishment?
Oh, beautiful.
Sexton try from Omoplata, shoulder lock.
Oh, that was nice. Use that to sweep Shimoishi and end up on top. One that minute. Is...
Have a look at Ariel Sexton do his thing. Some high-level BJJ.
Now back to Sexton.
Uppercut from Sexton. Shimoishi put everything behind that left hand and a southpaw start. Another left hand backs up Sexton there. The uppercut from the Costa Rican. Toe to toe. Now Sexton's hitting that left hand. Nice work here from Ariel Sexton.
I like the way he laced that leg to take away the base. Now he's on top. Now he's turtled up. Expect the ground pound. Oh, nope. He chooses to take the back instead.
Just going to be careful. Here's the set for the choke. It's more of a face crank at the moment, though.
Oh, it's under now.
And now it's under. Now the choke is in. On Shimoishi, Sexton right hand. Highland against a two-time BJJ champion.
Changing stances. Once he attacks, he's moving forward as he's marching.
Shimoishi jab. Outside leg kick. switches back to Orford.
Sexton looking in very good shape here. Mitch tracking around.
Right into the clinch now. Answers with a knee. Sexton's got a good base, and he just tossed.
He's got so many submission options. Shimoishi gets back to Artis. Oh, hip toss, beautifully done, judo style.
Oh, that was a beautiful hip throw by Shimoishi. That's that black belt in judo we were talking about. He goes right after with another.
Top position now for Shimoishi. Sexton back to his feet, eats a knee on the way up. Shimoishi through this contest. High left roundhouse kick, Mawashi get in. Out of his preferred chance for the knees here. Maybe a trip takedown, yes, from Shimoishi again.
But Shimoishi slides out of it. Heavy top pressure coming from Shimoishi. I think he's starting to work his way back up on the judges' scorecards here with some of these takedowns. Didn't even begin to describe Tarzan, but he's continually attacking. Doesn't matter.
We call it the Greystoke choke. How about that one for Tarzan? Now Shimoishi on top.
He's going to start moving off his back. Looking at a possible Kimura here, looking for it to sweep him. Oh, heavy hips coming from Shimoishi to stay on top.
Between rounds, how much the pin killer may have swung towards Shimoishi. Oh, chin is out. So too Shimoishi. Shimoishi, another driving takedown. Sexton won't stay there. Posts up on the left arm. Uppercut from Shimoishi, driving knee. Good duck under the hook there from Sexton, driving knee from the Costa Rican. Shimoishi inside of half guard. A little bit of ground and pass. Sexton up in the final seconds. Oh, tries to catch him on the way up. And Sexton knocks him down. Right on the bell. How about that?
Look at the stalking stance.
Shimoishi, who was so successful with the takedowns in the second round.
Oh, Ariel Sexton's down to snatch that Kimura. Letting those hands go. He's doing so well in the stand-up. Why is he trying to clinch? Maybe this is why. Maybe because he sees something in the ground and pound.
Big right hand, missed the target. Sexton takes the back down, Shimoishi. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Shimoishi in trouble! He's all tied up like a pretzel, and it's good! Night! Freaking Irene!
Teams at the moment is watching this. Liang, Wushu, martial arts. Chad, the one pushing forward and taking this center.
The power right leg, another chance for Atlan Gedion. Big outside start from Folayang.
Idiot is the one spinning first, which surprises me. That's a defensive weapon that will defend the kick.
Folayang cuts off the cage and almost cuts off his head with that side kick. Beautifully done from the Filipino. Now north-south position. Back to their feet. Showing power, showing strength. Who will win the tussle? Atlan Gedion throwing an elbow. Oh, the left hook from Folayang.
Nice little duck under from Atlan Gedion to end it. Possible guillotine, but I think he's just holding the head there. Chooses to let it go. Now he's going after a Kimura. He's going to have to turn his hips all the way to the side. He uses it to sweep Atlan Gedion. That was beautiful.
Folayang in full mount of the undefeated Russian. And now the ground and pound for the former world champion. Atlan Gedion gives his back. Here from Folayang, he flattens him out like a Russian pancake. Will he try to sink the choke? He may soften him up a little more.
Dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Folayang's trying to make quick work. Good control of the posture. Veteran experience right here from Folayang.
Look at Folayang taking his time, picking his shots, looking for the opening.
Needs to push off the legs a little bit. Folayang's heavy hips are making that very impossible. Those thunderous legs of his are not only good for kicking, but they're also good for control. But look at Atlan Gedion, big bridge out. Momentary minor mistake from Folayang cost him a very valuable position.
The Sambo champion now in top position. Gets to his feet, tries to run down the ground and power. Folayang glances towards his corner. Puts him inside the closed gate. Gedion to posture up and land those massive meat hooks.
Look for Folayang trying to look after that arm. So you see him trying to lean to that left side as he throws up an arm bar there. Folayang's been spending a lot of time on his jiu-jitsu game.
Said he put a lot of work into the... That said he was unfazed to go there, and certainly looks that way. Folayang back to his feet now, drifting there again. Skip up, controlling sensei. Oh, that was an overhand. Oh, side kick almost cuts him in half. Beautifully done, the Wushu styling from Folayang.
You can see a little bit of superficial damage starting to build on the left side of Angeliev's face.
But powerful performance. Tracking it.
Martin
Eduard Folayang is the second
Filipino, is on the super.
Right there from the Russian, face again, throws the overhand right. Follow back, coming side kick from Folayang.
Diving takedown, look at the domination control of Eduard Folayang, just to shrug off Angeliev like that.
2 minutes 45 remaining, second round of three. Knees from Folayang on the thigh of Angeliev from the leg kicks. Nice knee between the eyes, pulls out Folayang.
Angeliev searching for the single. Good defense from Folayang, really controlling the top position. Well, got him the lightweight belt in the first place, side kick that he likes so much.
Cracking leg kick, patient in the strike, and moves out of counter right. And again, does so with a head kick. Two punch combination. Defends the single leg attempt from Angeliev. There's a big right hand, smack bang to the beard.
Folayang mixing up the weapons really well. Jab to the head, straight to the body, goes in for the takedown, ends back up on top and just trying to smother him. But, oh, he's Folayang slides in the mouth. Well done.
Gets the back now of the Russian. Can he put the hooks in and flatten him out? No, chooses to stand. He's going to let him up.
Okay, Folayang sees something here.
Edward Folayang. He's got a big ball. Go back. He's from Atlanta. Getty is proving useless.
Big stoppage, like just running into a brick wall. Folayang got the underhook, stopped him right
from Folayang. Such an imposing figure. This is another round. The red trunks is in control, as he has for the previous air. Unsuccessful from Angeliev. Good sprawl to defend the takedown from Folayang. Folayang lifts
here, trying to beat, going to the head, and throwing kicks, slowing him down.
The performance of Folayang.
Angeliev's got to change the distance because right now he's being lured into the. Oh, there you go. Now he comes charging forward. That's what he has to keep doing. Keep pushing on
it. Overhand right to throw caution to the rear. Folayang outside. Not only a superstar in the Philippines, but popular wherever we go around Asia. Everybody loves Eduard Folayang.
He's so entertaining. He always puts on a show. Exceptional performance.
He likes the values he brings, which the true martial arts Bushido spirit, integrity.
So get them a little deeper, go on the inside. Always focus on the outside of what we're seeing, but I do like that point.
Forward edges, forward again. Spinning backwards. And around
what he caught him with is he stepped to the side in the open.
Oh, there it is. He must have heard you. Turn it back into the liver. How about that?
Almost on cue.
You know who's one of the biggest Eduard Folayang fans going around? Martin Ewan always tweets and Facebooks about Eduard Folayang. Loves watching Folayang.
Very true. I think everybody does. Good defense here. Angeliev trying to go for that single leg again, but good hip. Look at the pressure from his hips as he's sprawling down heavy.
The Russian up low against favor. Another cut.
And those punches.
That here come the turning kicks. They've never been on a stage this big, and they don't come any bigger than one championship on the planet. Folayang controls it. Big outside leg kick, sprawls out once more. This is superb.
Again, he throws that leg kick. He initially gets a shot for Angeliev and sprawls him.
And here the chance for something. Shaolin's put on a skin clinic. From the former world, he fights the Russian. He's got a hope right. Hail Mary shot now. He tries one with a jumping fourth right hand. It's not going to happen for Angeliev. It is going to happen for Eduard Folayang. The Filipino will be back in the winner's circle.
It looked like Eduard Folayang was trying a Peruvian necktie there at the end of the round. So here's that spinning back kick right to the lat there.
Put your hips down. Put your hips down. Hooks your hips down. Press your right side. You got it.